offers us a wonderful opportunity to refocus ourselves, our spiritual life, our entire being on the one thing needful, which is our salvation. Everything in this world will try to distract us and turn us away from that one thing which is needful. The passions, they will try to delude us. People will try to mislead us. The goods of this world will entice us. And yet there is only one thing needful in the midst of all of our temptations, in the midst of all of our difficulties, in the midst of all of our distractions, and that's to continue to focus on our salvation, which is only found in Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ revealing to us not only perfect God, but perfect man, who we are called to be, who we are meant to be, and ultimately everything that we can be. It's only in and with and through Christ who says, I am the vine and you are the branches. If a man abide in me, you will bear much fruit. But apart from me, what? You can do how much?
Nothing.
How much is nothing? It's not a lot, is it? And yet we do things every day like we think that we're something. When the reality is that without the Lord God and Savior of our life, we have nothing. And we are nothing. Why? Because we were created from nothing. But it's precisely this knowledge of our poverty and of our true state that empowers us to do mighty things for God. When we step out in obedience to God and to His commandments, when we step out in trust, like Peter did on the water, like the apostles did as they went to convert the world, it's up to us to respond to God. And that's precisely what faith is. It's our response to God. We have to do something. A lot of times we don't feel like doing anything. But the greatest thing that we can do often is something, because there's so much that could be done. Oftentimes we don't know what to do, but just do something. Tomorrow morning, do something. Pray. Fast. Call upon the name of the Lord. Make reconciliation tonight with somebody who you thought you couldn't make reconciliation with. Whatever it is, do something. It's the widow's two mites, that might purchase the kingdom. And this poverty of spirit is what we offer to the Lord. We don't offer Him all of the great things like the Pharisee that we do for God and that we do for everybody else. We don't offer Him any of those things. Why? Because they're His. The knowledge is, the reality is that God is the giver of every good thing. Everything that I have, what do I have, St. Paul says, that I have not received? Even that great gift of love, it's something that we had to receive in order to give. Have you ever met anybody that was not able to love because they were never loved as a child? I have. It's very sad. But it reminds us that that capacity to even love is something that's a gift. It's something that's a gift that comes from God Himself. We have nothing. And in this poverty, this is the beginning of the Beatitudes. Blessed are the poor in spirit, because it's theirs. Who have the kingdom of heaven or are advancing towards the kingdom of heaven because they recognize their poverty. It's so important for us this evening to start on the right foot. And the way that we do that is by asking mutual forgiveness of one another. We all fail in many, many ways. Life is very difficult, and that's what the Lord tells us. He says, St. Peter asks him, how many times should I forgive my brother? Seven times? And he said 70 times seven, which is basically a really big number, and it should just keep going after that. Why? Because if we want God to forgive us, we have to forgive ourselves. We have to forgive the other, and we have to continue to forgive. Why? Because we need the forgiveness that comes from God. And it's this point, it's precisely this point that proves to us the veracity that our faith is true. Why? Because God asks us to love and to bless and to forgive the people that hate us, the people that destroy us, and the people that kill us. And Father Sofroni says that Christ uttering from the cross, he says that if the Lord did not say from the cross, Father, forgive them, he said no one would be forgiven. But it's God who extends that great gift to us first, just like he extends love to us first. And it's us, it's our turn. It's our job, in turn, to offer that same forgiveness and that same love to others, without exception. If there's one person in this room that you cannot be reconciled with, guess what? The reality is that you will not be able to enter the kingdom. Why? Because if they're there, you won't be able to stay there. Because you can't, you wouldn't be able to tolerate them. You'd have to go. Father Cipriani says that if there's just one person that can't be in our heart, God can't be in our heart. And so as we extend this forgiveness to each other, which we all need, it's an opportunity to let God back in. And no matter how bad it's been and how difficult the struggle has been with our neighbors, with our friends, with our family, we have to ask for forgiveness and we have to extend that forgiveness. Why? Because it's in that moment, Father Cipriani says, that the Holy Spirit descends upon us and sanctifies us. As I mentioned this morning, he says, would you like to save the world? He says, forgive all. Forgive all without exception. The words that are spoken by the Lord are divine. Father, it says, and let forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. These are divine words, he says, and that when we offer them, the Holy Spirit comes down upon us and enables us to make them real. And in the process, we're sanctified and we find our salvation. There's only two words that the devil hates the most out of anything that you could possibly say to anybody else. There's two words that burn him to no end and that ultimately bring us to salvation. And those two words are forgiven. So as we begin this great fast, let us do something. And let us begin tonight with those two words that the devil hates but that the Lord loves. And on behalf of my unworthiness and any mistakes or failures that I've committed in this coming year, any time during the entire time I've been here, I ask you to forgive me. A sinner.